Okay, so we want to talk about interest and its relation to exponential functions. And so typically we see two interest formulas. One is compounded n number of times per year. And we'll talk about that. And the formula you usually see is a is equal to p 1 plus r over n to the nt power. Okay? And time is really the variable here. P is this principal value. And we call A this future value of your money, right? The value that it will be at some future date. R is this interest rate. And that's a decimal. So, for example, if your interest rate is 5%, in this formula we use 0.05. N is the number of compounding periods per year, and T is the number of years. So let's look at that for n. Usually that's done, most of these are pretty explicit in problems, except for this n sometimes trips students up. So n for n, it's just keywords. When we say it's compounded annually, that means n is 1. One time, it's compounded one time per year. And this compounding means the bank, let's say we're talking about a typical like savings account. In a typical savings account, that would mean that the bank is only calculating your interest one time per year on some maybe average value of your account or something like that. Okay, so compounded, the other word is semi-annually, or one of the other words. In that case, n is 2. We also have quarterly. N is 4. Monthly. N is 12. And daily. There's a convention. Let me make sure. We'll use 365. Okay. Okay. There's some convention for daily compounding. Okay, but that is kind of what we're talking about here. We'll do an example problem in a second. In the limit, like as you go to this idea of compounding more and more, let's say, compounding every minute, compounding every 30 seconds, we get this idea, the idea of continuous compounding. And that's like the idea of taking this and taking the limit as n goes to infinity of this function, right? And as when I do that, I get this PE to the RT. Okay? I'm not going to prove that that's true. But this is the idea, and this is the formula here that we use when interest is compounded continuously. Okay? So we don't need n. I'll just make a note. There's no n in this formula, right? Because it's compounding continuously. And you might be thinking to yourself, what bank is going to compound your interest continuously? None of them. That's the answer. But it does have applications to inflation and how inflation rate changes. So it does have real applications, and it is one of the models that we look at to examine certain parts of the economy. Okay, so let's do an example. Let's go back up. Oh yeah, I have it right here. Okay, let's do a simple problem. Find the amount of money accumulated in 5 years if $12,000 is invested at 8% interest and compounded annually. Okay, so let's do that. Annually is n is equal to 1. I use this interest for, or this formula for compounding interest. And when I plug in here, 12,000 is my principal. 8% is my interest rate, which is 0.08. And 5 years is T, right? So I get 12,000, 1 plus 0.08 divided by 1. This is a T, 1 times T. So 12,000, oops, oh, T is, I have to plug that in here. T is 5, right? 12,000 times 1 plus 0.08 to the 5th power. I get 17,631.94. Okay, let's do part B. B is quarterly, which means n is equal to 4. Otherwise, this is the exact same as the problem part A. So, and I get, when I plug that in, 17,831.37. You can see that if the bank will compound interest more frequently, it's better for you, right? You make more money. And compounding continuously, I don't have an N, but future value is P e to the RT, 12,000 e to the 0.08. times 5. And again, that little E button is located right by your above, usually above your LN button. So I'm going to do 12,000 and then hit the E button and put 0.08 times 5 in the exponent of that. And I get $17,901.90 if I round up. 90 cents. Okay? So this is just basic compound interest using this, but it is a primary example of how exponential functions are utilized in application. Okay, let me know if you have questions.